items. So today we are doing a makeup tutorial all about the basic or beginner friendly makeup that we talked about last week, or in our previous video rather. And we are starting off with our brows. I am using the Essence brow pencil. Actually, it's the eye pencil in the color or shade hot chocolate. I'm busy filling in the brows, so it's the top line or outline and then the bottom outline, and then you fill in the brow with hair like strokes, and then you take your spoolie brush to just brush that out. I'm then gonna go and proceed into actually cleaning my brows with my concealer from LA Girl, so my LA Girl Pro Concealer and my flat brush, and I'm gonna clean at the bottom, creating a curvy light brow, cleaning out all the parts that I do not like to get the shape that I do want. You know the drill, because there is a video on how I actually do my brows, but I just wanted to show you using all the products I mentioned on my last video. So after I've cleaned up my brow with the small flat brush, I'm gonna go ahead and take a bigger brush to just spread out the concealer that I've used to clean up my brow. I'm then gonna spread it out, or almost blend it out, so that when I then go on with the beauty blender, it's much more easier to actually blend and it doesn't really show. Yes, you want a clean brow, but you don't want people to see the concealer so much, so you gotta blend. I'm then gonna go on and use my Maybelline Baby Skin Pore Erasing Primer. You know I love this primer because I've got big pores, so it's a must for me to actually erase my pores. So I'm just gonna spread it all out on my face. So I'm not just gonna put it in one section, I'm gonna put it all over. Then I'm gonna go on with my Maybelline Fit Me foundation that everyone has been actually raving about. I'm just gonna squeeze it into my finger and then spread it out with my finger, and then I'm gonna go on with a brush and a beauty blender. So I'm gonna first go on with a brush to spread it out a bit, and then after I've done spreading it out throughout my face, because obviously it's not gonna blend as nicely as I want it to, because it's gonna leave those streaky lines. And so after I'm done with the brush and try to blend it around my face as much as possible, I'm then gonna go on with my beauty blend. I don't really like the brush because I feel like this kind of brush actually just takes away so much product. It's not dense enough as I'd like it. So I'm going in with my beauty blender, trying to use that to just blend all over my face and create a flawless look, as you know. And then I'm gonna put on more foundation and just try and spread it out evenly as possible throughout my face, and you know you have to try and get as close as possible to the hairline so that it doesn't create a mask like look, it can have a skin like finish. Then I'm gonna go on and use my LA Girl Pro Concealer to highlight under my eyes, my cupid's bow, below my mouth, my forehead, and on the bridge of my nose. So I'm using the shade Fawn, and I sometimes also use Warm Honey and Cool Tan for this, but currently I think I'm using Warm Honey. And I'm busy just spreading that around. So you know the drill, nom noms. You have to blend. I am actually currently using my beauty blender to blend that out, to blend the highlighter out. By highlight, I mean the concealer that I use to actually highlight. blending as much as possible to create a flawless look. We all gotta look flawless. You don't wanna have lines. You don't wanna show where the highlight, the concealer or the highlighter stops and starts. You want everything to just blend and look as natural as possible. So I'm busy doing that right now, and I'm gonna be doing that for a while. So after you've done a beauty blending, we're actually going to go and use our Dark Cocoa LA Girl Pro Concealer to contour under my cheekbones, on my forehead, on the outline of my forehead actually, and then on the outlines of the bridge of my nose. So I'm trying to create structure now. I'm bringing structure and that snatched look to my face right now. Another tip, nom noms, for that more snatched on fleek look, you want to actually contour on your jawline as well, so that you can just improve that snatched look. So now we're going to go into baking. Obviously we're using our Yardley loose powder and the caramel, and I'm using those color sponges that I told you about, and I'm actually just baking where I actually highlighted with my concealer. And then I'm also going to just take a beauty blender and try to spread out the contouring that I had just done with my LA Girl Dark Cocoa. So that's why I didn't put a lot, because this color is so pigmented and deep that I don't need to put so much. I can just spread it out. And then after that, I'm going to take my brush and dip into my bronzing shades from the LA Girl blush palette, and then I'm just gonna go on and put that where I actually contoured to create a more blended but contoured look. So whenever you have creams, make sure that you have a powder that you're gonna go over with to actually set it, so that it does not crease, it does not melt, it does not crack. So basically that's what I'm doing right now, trying to blend out and also set the creams that I had put before. So I'm also going in with a beauty blender, just trying to blend out the contour that was on my nose. And then after that, I take a brush and then I try to just blend everything out. Guys, probably like 60% of the time just goes on to blending, because you want things to come together. You don't want like things to be separate. You want everything to come together because it's a face, you know. It has to work out all together. So now I'm going on to my eyeshadow. I'm using the LA Girl eyeshadow palette that I showed you in the previous video. I'm going on with the color that I had shown you as a transition color, and then I'm taking a light pink color and actually going more closer to the lid than the crease. And I'm trying to end by the crease and not go over the crease. Just trying to create gradient in my eye. And then I'm gonna take my MOD setting spray, because I want the eyeshadow to be more pigmented. So I'm spraying my brush so that when I actually dip it into the eyeshadow, it actually looks more pigmented. Then I'm going on with a darker shimmery color at the tip of my eyelids to create more gradient. I'm almost doing like a halo sort of kind of like look, as you can see. So I'm going on the tip, and then I'm making sure that I am going on top, like on the crease line, to join onto another, onto the other tip. So as you can see, in your perspective, it might seem that the video, I'm actually working very fast, but the video is just sped up. This is not the actual real speed. So I am actually just taking my time to actually blend. I just took a shimmery pink color, and then I'm going in where I had not touched with the dark color. So I'm creating a halo like look. And as you can see, what I had done is that with the darker color, I tried to create like a wing like look, so that my liquid eyeliner that I'm actually using now may follow uniform into that wing like look on the eyeshadow colors. So that was the reason why I actually applied the eyeshadow the way I did, because I knew I was gonna do a wing look with my liquid eyeliner. So it also depends what kind of shape you want with your eyeshadow and what eyeliner shape you will actually use. So I'm actually just creating a wing liner with my Yardley Precision liquid eyeliner. So now I'm actually taking my concealer brush with some concealer, because I did kind of go out of the line that I wanted to, and I'm just cleaning up. So sometimes you don't have to worry when you're actually applying eyeshadow. You can always clean it up at the end. So I'm just doing that where the wing liner stops, because I don't want any eyeshadow color passing that eyeliner wing liner, if you get what I'm saying. And then I'm just cleaning that out with my sponge so that it's more neater and the concealer is blended into my skin and foundation. I'm then taking my Yardley Volume Lash mascara, and I'm just trying to lengthen my eyelashes and just give them volume with this mascara, because it is a volume lash mascara after all. So that's what I am actually doing right now. Explaining everything that you need. More water, less stress, more sex, more carefree. Don't wanna hurt no more, not over me. Cause I'm not worth it. This ain't working and running out. And then I'm actually going with my eyeshadow brush, and I'm actually putting a shimmery gold color in my tear ducts to create that highlighted look near my eyes and to just make my eyes pop. And then taking another brush and highlighting below my eyebrows with that highlighter shade that's from my blush palette. So what's nice about that blush palette is very versatile. It's got a bronzer, blush and highlighter, and I'm just literally working that highlighter on top of my cheekbones, and everywhere near the end of my eyebrow to create that glow. Honey, look at that glow. So make sure that when you actually apply your highlighter, it's just it's on the side, so it only has to show when you actually turn, and it shouldn't actually be where it shouldn't be under your eye. And then I'm also highlighting the bridge of my nose, on my cupid's bow. You know, I like highlighter. And then I'm just putting on some setting spray. And for my lipstick, I'm going to be using the Essence Matte Lip Gloss in the shade 2. And also the lipstick is also matte in the shade 2 as well. And I am literally going to first start with my lipstick, and then I'm going to go on top with my lip gloss just to create almost like a shimmery, goldy look. This is a nice like winter autumn look with a bit of zazz with that lip color. I'm really loving this look. I hope you loved it too. Please don't forget to subscribe and like. I love you, nom noms.